Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are working on animals, and this is for the animal hop for April, and a bunch of us are using this theme and are scrapbooking some animals. Now I do a hop that highlights my fur babies. So this one, I decided in the spirit of trying to finish up my Hawaii album, or at least make a dent in it, I am going to scrapbook about the mongoose that was very prevalent while we were in Hawaii. So one of them is a picture that I had taken on a hike, and another is a picture I had taken of the actual little mongoose, and I am just using some Echo Park paper, and I'm actually using the B side, and this is going to be basically a one sheet of pattern paper layout, and the rest I am going to use embellishments. So if you are low on pattern paper, this is a really easy way to just rely on your embellishments and only use that as your background paper. Now, I am not one who is low on pattern paper. I tend to be one that gets too much, but I thought that it would be fun to just kind of rely on this one sheet and then really look at the embellishments that I have. So I've cut down my photo and added my journaling, and the journaling is basically just going to give some information about the small Asian mongoose, and then I have a package of embellishments from 49 and Market, and I believe I have some from Simple Stories, and I also have some of them from I believe Scrapbook Customs. So I'm just kind of going through my ephemera pack, looking through to see what will work and what colors I want to use. There is a ton in these embellishment packs, and I tend to forget about things that I have, and so sometimes it's fun to just look through your stash and see what is out there and what you can use and layer and that sort of thing. So I did find this larger piece, which is going to force me to pull my picture up a little bit. That's okay. The glue that I use is repositionable to an extent. So I'm just going to pull that up real gently so that I don't rip my paper, and just put that underneath so it's just showing a little bit behind it. I think it gives it a fun edge, and this is another alternative to using additional pattern paper. You can rely on frames or things like that. So now I'm going to build up my embellishment clusters. I really like that little leafy embellishment, and I have a few of them that I'm just going to start filling up space and just build some interest. Hopefully the point is not to detract from the photos, but to add a little bit of visual interest and to draw your eye then back to the photos. So all of my embellishments are going to be surrounding my photos to bring your eye into the center of the page. So I have a couple of little tickets here that I'm going to add on and glue down that little foliage, which I think is super cute, and just kind of look and see what more I have. I like those little tabs. I have a bunch of tabs, and they used to be really popular. I have not used them as much as I should, and that might actually be kind of a fun project at some point to just see what I could do on a layout using just tabs. I guess we'll see. If that sounds like something that would be fun to watch, or if there is a product that you struggle with, leave me a comment and I'll see if I can accommodate for you. See if we can find some harder to use products or less used products, and see if we can use them up. So now I've got these 3D embellishments from Simple Stories. They're kind of a foam, and I think it works. I really liked that there was a lot of things that said something about trail and nature, and I decided to use this one because I have sort of that pinkish color on the left, so I wanted to continue to bring it around. It is quite sticky, I found, so I am going to have a little bit of trouble getting it back up because that little yellow spot right above it bugged me. So I'm going to figure out a way to fix that, as you'll see coming up, but in the meantime, I'm going to leave it there until I can figure out what I want to do with it. So, there I am trying to pull it up again because I'm like, oh, this is, I can't leave it that way. I've got to pull it up. Like you'll see, it tears my paper a little bit, but that's okay because I'm going to cover it up. And, like Bob Ross said, no mistakes, just happy accidents. So this is going to be one of my happy accidents. I'm going to pull that, tag on there, that piece of ephemera, and, then I will have plenty of room and also not have that gaping yellow space. So, and I think it works. I think my title ends up a little more in the spot that I want it to be to begin with. So now I'm going to look through just to make sure that I have everything that I need. And I'm trying a few things out. I really like all these butterflies, and I wanted to add a few. So I'm just going to kind of figure out where I want them to go. I did want to bring a little bit more of that pink since I only have it in two spots. So I want to make sure that I have it in at least three places so that there's sort of a visual triangle there. So I think I do them on camera, but I may have moved some of them off camera. So I'm still on a quest to see if there's anything else that I need. I am finding, oh look, I have a few more butterflies. I've got that. There's the pink that I was looking for. So I have accomplished that triangle there. And now I'm just going to continue to look through. I really like this little frame too. Again, that's something that used to be super popular, but we've kind of got away from. And I like when I have a chance to be able to use that, especially since the mongoose that's there in my picture is kind of small. We didn't get really close to it. I'm not really all that familiar with a mongoose since I live in the Midwest. We don't have a lot of them, but I didn't want to disturb it. So I kind of left it be and kind of zeroed in. So now I'm going to look to see if I have any other. I think I want to add a few enamel dots to my clusters. And just add a little bit of visual interest there, a little bit more dimension. I don't like mine too lumpy bumpy, but I'm okay with something like that. And then I think I will finally find some of those butterflies. I didn't really like the butterfly was over there all by itself, so I wanted to add a few more. I could have left it just fine the way it was, and I would have been happy with it, but I did want to go ahead and add a few more. So while I'm finishing that up, of course, I wanted to remind you that there are several people who are hopping along with us for this month's hop that we do. It's a themed hop that we do on the first Saturday of every month. And so I will list everyone who is playing along so that you can check out their channels as well. If you like this video, make sure you're hitting that like button. And here's something important, guys. If you're not yet subscribed to my channel, it would make me so happy if you could hit that subscribe button as well. Your support of my channel means just so much to me. So since I'm only using one piece of paper, I did want to give it a bit of an edge, and I'm just going to go ahead and freehand this. You could use a ruler, but I kind of like the freehand look. I'm just taking a black marker, and I'm just outlining the page. I think it just gives a little bit more visual interest. And there I have hyped up all those butterflies, and I didn't end up doing it on camera, but there you'll see I added those final little butterflies, and that is going to be it for my layout. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Have a magical day, everyone.